Just thinking. Yesterday, I watched the movie 7 Pounds starring Will Smith. Spoiler alert, I'm going to be talking about this movie, so if you haven't seen it, don't listen, because I'll be ruining the plot for you. So, what's this movie have to do with narcissism? Just one thing really, and that would be Will Smith's character's agenda. Now, I'm not saying that Smith is a narcissist, not in the least. In fact, his character is the exact opposite. In the movie, Will's character is beyond depressed. One fateful evening when he just proposed to the love of his life, they have an oncoming collision with an entire family in a minivan. One presumes he's the only survivor. That said, his character goes on a mission that isn't figured out until the end, and only by his brother. All through the entire movie, you're left wondering what he is doing and why. It is the people he encounters, especially the girl who needed the heart transplant, who are left perplexed by his actions. They keep asking, "Why me? Why are you doing this for me?" And the girl in need of the heart, at times, gets angry with him because he won't tell her what he is doing and why. You were really left wondering what the hell was going on. However, because he didn't seem to be duplicitous in nature, people let him slide, after being tested by him, again and again. Having no idea, he was planning to kill himself in the end, to give them his organs as a gift for their good deeds and good nature, they played along, none the wiser. It was this very thing about them, their good-heartedness, self-sacrifice, and slowness to anger, he was looking for. He would give away his home to a battered woman and her children, he would donate his eyes to a blind man, and he would literally, and figuratively give his heart to a young woman he fell in love with so she could live to see another day. Well, how does this relate back to narcissism, you might ask? The agenda. To best describe what I lived would be to describe the narc's agenda. That testing of the characters in the movie, their expressions of sometimes anger, because they couldn't point out what was going on, the giving of the benefit of the doubt over and over again, because Will's character was endearing and unassuming, was what it was like being with a full-blown NPD aka sociopath. I recall looking at the narc and saying, "And if I said it once, I must have said it 1,000 times. What did you mean by that? What's going on? Why did they say that? What a coincidence. Why are you doing that? What just happened?" After he turned an entire argument around on me, blaming me for what he did. Furthermore, in my own minds I heard myself saying, "What the hell was that?" After a narc rage and word salad. Why did he do that? What the F? Who does that? Concerning other people, like friends and family, I would say to the narc, "Of course, now I know now, he'd been smearing me. Why did they say that? They seem angry, I wonder what's wrong? Did I do something wrong? Did I say something wrong?" Oh yes, he would answer these questions of mine with simple statements like, "That's just how they are," or "Nothing's wrong." Insert massive gaslighting here. Lastly, my point is that if a narc is running an agenda, which they usually are, they will be testing your good nature, and your ability to give the benefit of the doubt. And they don't just do this to you, they are doing it to everyone else. They are moving you around like game pieces on a chessboard to suit their reality. Like little kids, they play act, they tell the story, they order everyone around in place to suit their narrative. This looks like a psychosis, but it's not. Narcs need people, because people give them what they need: attention, admiration, adulation, etc. This will account for the uneasiness you feel around them, because they are lying. They are the people of the lie, Beck. I know I'm not the only one who felt this way around the narc, I can think of a few others that did as well. Every once in a while he'd get caught in a lie about me, however, what's one lie, right? Most people who are not interpersonally entangled with them would probably let it slide, given his unassuming, good guy persona. Well, I got news for you folks, that agenda destroyed every area of my life, like it was meant to. Keep in mind this is an all-pervasive disorder, So if he's doing it to me, he's doing it to everyone else. Do you really want to take your chances with a psychopath? Now that I know what I know, learning the very hard way, nope, no way in hell would I ever dance with the devil again. He's only harmless if you say hi, how ya doing and keep going. Anyway, that's it for now, and not sure if that helped anyone today, but I was just thinking. Love to all, and peace out.